Crisis fatigue. Causes and symptoms. Situations that cause ongoing stress can take a toll on the mind and body. Crisis fatigue is a response to the prolonged stress that develops due to unexpected or difficult events such as war, economic depressions, or a pandemic. This video will take a closer look at crisis fatigue, including causes and symptoms and how to cope. What is crisis fatigue? Crisis fatigue is a term that people use to describe a burnout response to the chronic stress that challenging events can cause. It is not a formal medical diagnosis, but people who feel that they are experiencing crisis fatigue may have very real mental or physical symptoms. Some examples of situations that can lead to crisis fatigue include wars, political instability, economic depressions, pandemics, natural disasters, racial injustice. A person may experience stress due to the crisis itself or due to its secondary consequences. For example, a person may feel acute stress during a tropical storm, but long-term stress if they lose their home and possessions because of it. What causes crisis fatigue? During a crisis, people often experience stress or the fight, flight, or freeze response. This is the body's way of preparing for danger. The symptoms of stress can include an elevated heartbeat, fast or shallow breathing, muscle tension, increased sweating. This response is usually short-term and resolves on its own when a person feels safe again. However, during a prolonged crisis such as a pandemic, people can feel unsafe or threatened for long periods of time with few breaks. This long-term stress or allostatic load can take a toll on the body, affecting a person's hormones and neurotransmitters. Without having time to get back to a more restful state, people can begin to experience symptoms of fatigue. Signs and symptoms. Some of the possible symptoms of crisis fatigue include physical and mental exhaustion, changes in sleep such as sleeping more or less than usual, changes in appetite, feeling numb or empty. People experiencing general emotional distress during a prolonged crisis may also feel anxious or helpless, lack empathy for others, have unexplained body aches or pains, use alcohol, drugs, or cigarettes more frequently, become withdrawn, have difficulty returning to work or school, have difficulty concentrating. These symptoms can last for weeks or months, and they may be worse if the crisis seems or feels indefinite. Who does it affect most? Anyone can experience crisis fatigue. However, frontline workers and other people the crisis most severely impacts are likely to be most affected. For example, during a pandemic, healthcare workers and emergency responders can have long shifts and ongoing stress with little time to recuperate. Mental health clinicians and news reports are also extremely vulnerable to crisis fatigue. Some people are also at higher risk of mental health conditions in general than others. This includes people who have experienced trauma, a pre-existing mental health condition, poverty, homelessness, discrimination, unemployment or financial uncertainty, bereavement as a result of the crisis, limited mobility, How to cope with crisis fatigue? Dealing with crisis fatigue can be challenging, as the event causing the problem is typically outside of a person's control and may continue for a long time. Recognizing the need to look after one's physical and mental health during a crisis is a positive step and likely one's greatest protective factor. Some strategies that may help someone cope with the symptoms of crisis fatigue include the following. Take a break. Taking time off of work to rest and recover may be critical to recovery. Take advantage of sick days and leave policies to give oneself a much needed break from stressful environments. Disconnect from media. During a crisis, media coverage is typically persistent and intrusive in our daily routines. Taking a few days to disconnect from news coverage and all social media can help a person reset and become less numb. Maintain a routine. A crisis can disrupt a person's usual schedule. Maintaining a routine or adopting a new one can help people feel a sense of normalcy and control. It may also help people establish a regular sleep schedule. Ask for help. If someone is struggling, help is available. Neighbors, friends, or family may be able to provide practical help, such as picking up groceries. Organizations that provide aid may be able to offer financial assistance. Talk to someone. Talking to people who understand a situation can help a person feel less alone. Even if there are no obvious solutions, if possible, it may be beneficial to talk to a mental health professional. Try a hobby. Hobbies can take a person's mind off of their situation and give them something else to focus on. For example, during the COVID-19 pandemic, people have tried new hobbies that they can do at home. Get some physical activity. Exercise can be another way to relieve stress and give a person something else to focus on. Activities such as yoga, tai chi, walking, or aerobics are free and do not usually require any equipment. Long-term impact. People with crisis fatigue may feel better when they are no longer in the situation that is causing it. However, for some, the crisis will have a lasting impact. People who experience severe or ongoing stress for any reason can develop psychological trauma. Trauma is a response to emotional pain or shock, and it can affect people in a variety of ways. During or after a traumatic event, a person may feel exhausted, confused, sad, agitated, numb, disconnected from their thoughts, feelings, or experiences. People can also develop vicarious trauma, which occurs after witnessing something traumatic happen to somebody else. For example, emergency responders and healthcare workers often experience this type of trauma. Once the traumatic event is over, most people recover and do not continue to experience these symptoms in everyday life. However, some people may develop post-traumatic stress disorder or PTSD, which is a long-term condition. The symptoms of PTSD include, but are not limited to, flashbacks or persistent memories of the trauma, hyperarousal or hypervigilance, wherein a person feels like they are constantly on high alert, difficulty sleeping or nightmares, depression. Trauma and PTSD are treatable conditions. If a person has any symptoms of these conditions, they may find help in a trauma ward doctor or therapist.